Thank you. Thank you very much indeed, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the Richardson Auditorium. Yay! Yeah. And happy holidays and very Merry Christmas to all of you. Thank you for coming out on this miserable English day. Yeah, now, it's like 300 days of the year back in England, but at least we've got some hope of sunshine this coming week, right? Did you like your opening set there? Yes? Now, of course, our second piece, you may have noticed from the programme, our second piece, Gale Force, has absolutely nothing to do with the holidays whatsoever. But we just knew you'd love that Irish music. Isn't that great? That's great stuff, isn't it? Really wonderful. Now, we're in for many treats today, me included, actually, and here comes one of them right now. Because the tenor horn, which is the middle of the band, was one of the instruments invented by Adolf Sax, but rarely heard in solo performance, and certainly rarely heard outside of the hands of someone like the soloist that we're about to listen to right now. Ailsa Russell has become a great friend. You can read about her in the programme. And you're going to now be introduced to the wonders and the miracles of the beautiful sound of the tenor horn, as Ailsa comes to play as one of the most, in my opinion, one of the most terrific and moving of all carols. This is In the Bleak Midwinter, collected by the English composer Gustav Holst. And I'll just give you the first verse just to set the tone, because this is very English and... In the bleak midwinter, frosty wind made moan. Earth stood hard as iron, water like a stone. Snow had fallen, snow on snow, snow on snow. In the bleak midwinter, long ago. Please put your hands together for Ailsa Russell, our tenor horn solo. what a beautiful piece. Now, we have another beautiful piece here of a different stripe, because today I'm delighted to be able to welcome back to the stage here the good doctor James Borowski, who used to be a regular member of the band, but now he's famous. He's become famous, and he's now playing regularly in New York, even to the point where we have to feature him at this point in the program, because he's going to be taking off straight for Berlin after this concert. He doesn't even speak to me anymore, he's that famous. But as all of you know, we're in for a real treat here, because James is the absolute master of the bass trombone. He's our traditional frosting. Just wouldn't be the holiday concert without him. So let's please put our hands together and be welcome for some audience participation in Frosty the Snowman with James Brown.
Thank you.
definitely one for the memory books for us, because James came out here and suddenly realised his music wasn't there. So right on the spur of the moment, he played that whole thing from memory and instinct. So I think he deserves a special. Festival today. If you look at the program, you can see we're featuring a lot of different soloists. And this year we have, at great expense, all the way from England, for the third year, Tom Hutchinson on cornet coming to play for us right now. And I said to the board, I don't get it, because I said to the board, aren't you sick of him? We've had him 2 years already, right? Once, twice, but never thrice. Are you sure you want him back? And I tried with all my might and main to stop them, but at the end of the day, I was overruled. So it's with very great reluctance, and not a little bad attitude, that I'm now very proud to welcome back, because of course we love him, and we love to have him 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 20 years in a row. The amazing, the magical Tom Hutchinson!
Actually, actually, this is the first time I've been in the Richardson Auditorium. I've got to tell you what a fantastic place this is to play. Well, me and Ailsa, we arrived on Friday morning. We actually landed in Newark at 11 a.m. from London. So those of you that are quick with your maths will figure out that the flight was actually 8 a.m. on Friday morning from the UK. And being from Wales, Wales is a good 3 hours away from London. So if you do your maths again, that would mean that we'd have had to leave my house at 2 a.m. on Friday morning. Working backwards from that, 4 hours prior to that, we just finished a recording. So we've been catching up on a little bit of sleep since we got here. But we have been really, really well looked after, as usual, by Charlie and Steve. It's a fantastic brass band to be playing with, and such a special concert to be part of. So again, a massive thank you to Steve and Charlie for inviting us over. Well, 2018 has been a real mixed bag. There's been some highs and lows for myself. And I'll start with a real high. One of the most proud things that I've done this year is release my second solo CD. I was lucky to be awarded the British Bandsman Solo CD of the Year and the Brass Band World Solo CD of the Year. So it's been quite a good ride over the past couple of months. And all the pieces, all the tracks that were on the CD this time were pieces of music which were personal to me in some way. And the next piece is no exception at all. The next piece I'm going to play is a piece by Haydn Wood called A Brown Bird Singing. And when we arrived on Friday, myself, Steve, Ailsa and Laurel, we went to dinner. Was it the Salt Creek? Is that the right one? Yeah, the Salt Creek, okay. And we actually met a good friend of ours, Jerry Reif. He plays at Charlie's house party every year. He's an amazing, amazing clarinetist. And I was explaining to him the solos I was going to be playing today. I told him that I was going to be playing Brown Bird Singing, and he expressed his love for this piece, and this is one of his favourite composers. So I'm not sure where you are, Jerry, but this one is for you. This is A Brown Bird Singing.
Thank you.
Wow, how about that? It's super, isn't it? What a masterclass in the old English style of brass band playing. Can you hear it almost like it's singing, isn't it? It's almost like a singing style. Almost doesn't sound like a brass instrument, does it? It sounds like a voice that's singing. Absolutely wonderful. Now, you guys haven't been doing much so far, have you? You're a lazy. Do you want to do something?
Yeah.
Do you want to sing? Let's have an audition. Let's have an audition. We might do a piece next year for brass band and choir. Let's see how many of you manage to make it into the choir, okay? Now, we won't stand because I know that, you know, it's the holidays. We're at rest. So we'll stay seated, right? But I'm going to ask for straight backs, please. Rolled shoulders. Nice open throats. Let all the stress of 2018 flow out of your fingertips as we sing some Christmas carols together. Are you ready? Now, for those of you that although it's Sunday, this is not a religious worship service today, okay? So if you feel so disposed, please feel free to sing the lyrics that are written in your songbooks, your program, okay? If you don't feel so disposed, feel free to sing in the original Latin. Fa la la, la la la. The whole point of this exercise is to have a great time with some of these superb tunes. So whatever you decide to sing, sing it with all your heart. Are you with me?
Yes.
So enough of this jabber for me. Let's get the band going and then we can sing some of these songs. Right.
Thank you.
You are, without doubt, the most wonderful audience we've ever had. Look, in fact, it's you I like. It's not the things you wear. It's not the way you do your hair. But it's you I like. The way you are right now. The way deep down inside you, not the things behind you, but it's you I like. Every part of you, your skin, your eyes, your feelings, whether old or new, I hope that you'll remember, even when you're feeling blue, that it's you I like. It's you, your very self. Yes, it's you I like. Fred Rogers. Mr. Rogers. What a wonderful character. Now, let me change things up a little bit, because the band get very restive. We like to, in our programs, we always like to give the band something to give, sink their teeth into. Some red meat at the end of the first half. Are you guys all ready for red meat? Or are you vegetarians or vegans? We have a little vegetable and vegan for you in the second half. But for right now, it's going to be raw steak. We're going to play you one of the greatest of all American composers, in my humble opinion. Growing up as a kid in England, Lenny Bernstein was on television at least once a week, and he was doing everything, wasn't he? He was on television, educating, he was conducting, he was playing the piano. What was it Lenny wasn't doing? And apart from that, he just happened in his spare time to write music that changed Broadway history. How nice. Thank you, Lenny. I'm going to play you now a really great arrangement, but for my money, one of the greatest. And this will give you really the stink and the stench of Manhattan in a way that only Leonard Bernstein could really write. It's called Lonely Town, and it's about sailors that come to Manhattan, and two of them go off to have a wild time, while the other one, Gaby, who's a little bit of an innocent, he sees a poster of this really beautiful woman, and rather than throwing himself around, he's decided he's going to make it his mission to find this woman, fall in love with her, and make him marry her. So the first movie, if you look at the program, the first movie is called The Great Lover. This is Gaby going to rescue his damsel in distress. But then the second movement is Lonely Town, where Gabe is in Central Park, and he actually sees a lover's fight, a lover's quarrel, and the lovers break apart, and it brings back this existential dread of being alone in this world. Gabe is not living in an I like you world. So the final movement is Times Square, 1944. So Gabe comes back, he reunites with his fellow sailors, and they just enjoy the delights of Manhattan in midsummer. Check this out, it's Ray Farr's arrangement of the